In what could be a CES first, Samsung's big product for 2019 is a smaller TV. After impressing last year with a 146-inch model, in 2019 the micro LED technology is in a 4K 75-inch set. That's actually a step higher engineering challenge, as Samsung's Andrew Savory explained to me.
With this technology, with micro LED, the challenge to being able to create a smaller, more consumer-friendly size of television was in getting pixel density to be tighter. But to get pixel density tighter, you physically needed chipsets to get smaller and closer together. So with Samsung's experience in semiconductor, we were able to go ahead in advance and bring that spacing down to make it small enough to where I could get pixel density where it needed to be to facilitate a size as small as 75-inch.
So what are the plans for commercialization for this?
Yeah, so there'll be some news released on this a little later in the year about availability and for pricing. But the way we see it is the applications of micro-LED really become endless now. It can really change the way people think about how they would put a display in their home and how they would utilize that display. So we think it's going to really force everyone to think differently.
The plan is for larger micro-LED displays to be made up of a number of display modules connected together. Samsung hopes it will give much greater flexibility for screens to break out of the 16:9 form factor and to play a more important part in a home's decor.
The most common application, I think, is always going to be some of the base sizes. So a 75-inch screen is a great unit to build off of. But we think once designers and decorators and just homeowners in general start thinking about different ways that they might utilize this in the home, that's where you're going to see some of the more modular blocks start being more popular and then those being sold. I don't expect that at day one it's a box of, hey, here's 16 panels, go build a display. But we think it'll be evolutionary and it will get there.
Micro-LED is Samsung's new screen technology introduced last year. The screen itself is made up of millions of LEDs that directly emit light. It's a very different technology to today's LCD and OLED TVs, and is Samsung's answer to OLED, a technology that's been mastered by its South Korean rival LG Electronics. And it was to OLED that Savory was quick to claim superiority.
So at the end of the day, obviously self-emissive technology is the way to create the most accurate color and of course the best contrast, right? So there are some inherent challenges with other technologies like OLED, but just specifically the fact that it's organic. So by its very nature, it's not going to perform the same way over a long length of time. Micro-LED is inorganic, again, just almost a solid state. So you will get that same performance from day one until many years in the future. So the biggest advantage is being able to duplicate the image that customers want to see, to get the realism, to get the immersion, and to be able to do it in a way that's repeatable just day after day.
You can't go out and buy a micro LED TV just yet, but that's not the only technology Samsung has lined up for 2019.
So we think besides this, what's really here and now, and in fact, what you can go out and buy today is 8K. And 8K is really going to change the way customers look at television. And to be very frank, we know that there's some skepticism from folks saying, well, why do you even need 8K? And I point out to what different research firms said when 4K launched back in 2012. One of my favorite quotes, I wish I could attribute the specific author that wrote it, the headline said, why 4K is stupid and why you don't need it. And now, of course, it's the baseline, it's what people expect. So 8K is going to go ahead and really change the way people look at TV. It's going to change a lot of the rules for how big of a screen can fit in a room, how close you can or can't sit to a TV, and just adds a whole new sense of depth and realism to your television viewing experience.
And of course, TV is not just about the picture, it's about the audio as well.
Of course.
What's happening on the audio
side?
So
what we've done, and this is across not just our 4K lineup, but our 8K lineup as well, you'll hear us talking a lot about AI or artificial intelligence, and we've brought that into sound as well. So what we've done this year, you'll see a display when you walk through here this evening. We've got the ability with our chip, with a couple of unique algorithms, to actually analyze what type of sound is being reproduced. Is it voice during a newscast? Is it a sporting event? Is it a dramatic explosion in a movie? And we can actually go ahead and tweak and tailor the sound to make even the TV's internal speakers sound better because it's made those adjustments with that algorithm. So again, the limits here are endless.